Dockrys then, and of course they've all got local Welsh native on their roofs as well. To the end of the high street here. Very much a Welsh-speaking town here, as will be many of the ones we're going to go through on the tour today. lots of first language Welsh speakers. And there's also a famous male voice choir here in the town. It's called Cor Mabion. Cor Mabion. That's about C-O-R, which is a Welsh word for choir. And then Mabion, M-E-I-B-I-O-N, Mabion. It's 60 strong male voice choir. And they practice in the local school hall. And when they're practicing, I've taken them. And they end up in tears because the sound that they make is so wonderful. But anyway. The male voice choirs came about because of slate mining and slate quarrying. The male voice choirs came about in the coal mines and the slate mines because during lunch times or after work, very dangerous heavy, where the red arrows are, red and white arrows are, and it'll tell you about his role as a quarryman and how dangerous it was and dirty it was. And so another thing you can do is a thing called bounce below. They are big trampolines. The empty quarries below ground. There's a great fun. And then finally last year, believe it or not, they opened up a golf course underground. A golf course. It's a pitch and putt. It's not a championship. Well, I haven't seen it yet. It only opened up about 6 months ago. And so I used to play golf many years ago before I became a guy. But I've no idea. I do know it's a pitch and putt, and that's all I can tell you about it. It's got 18 holes, I think. Underground in the former slate quarry. That's something else, isn't it? The road that we're travelling on now is known as the Crimea Path. And there's a reason for that. Back in the 1800s, mid-1800s, we were fighting the Russians, nothing new there, fighting the Russians in an area called the Crimea in Eastern Europe. We were taking prisoners of Russian soldiers. And so those Russian soldiers, the prisoners, that we got were actually brought here to North Wales and were put to work building this road, and that's how it came to be known as the Crimea Pass. But you've got some lovely views now over on your left there towards the mountains of Snowdonia, the higher mountains over there. The highest mountain in Snowdonia National Park is Mount Snowdon, which is 3,560 feet high. If you're into your metric, 1,080 metres. That's further over to our west. There's a range of mountains in Snowdonia which are all over 3,000 feet. Some of them, one of them we'll see after lunch as we head into the mountains, one of the more difficult ones to climb. But now we're going to something called the Dolwyddelen Pass. Dolwyddelen Pass. And before we get into the village itself, the Dolwyddelen, by the way, on your left there, you can just see
Great friends, because Thomas Wynne had trained to be a
they both decided to escape their religious persecution. So they got on the ship Welcome in the late 1600s, and they traveled for a new life in the USA. And they founded Pennsylvania. And it was Thomas Wynne himself from North Wales who founded the city of Philadelphia. And he built himself a house there called Wynnstay, W-Y-N-N-S-T-A-Y. And I think the remains of it are still there today. Lots of Welsh names, therefore, in, around Philadelphia, and also the state of Pennsylvania, too. There's a town called North Wales in Pennsylvania. Had their heritage here in North Wales. One was the author of your Declaration of Independence, Thomas Jefferson. He was born at the foot of Mount Snowdon, a place called Sunberis. And the other one was Abraham Lincoln, a tiny village, just a few miles, about 5 miles from the coach park at Betws-y-coed. Betws-y-coed translates as the prayer house in the woods. Very alpine field, and lots of indigenous species as well. So very, very, lots of greenery around this. And there are three rivers that meet in Betws-y-coed. The Conwy, the Tligwy, which we will follow after lunch. The Conwy, the Tligwy, and the Sledder. Try saying that after a pint. The Conwy, the Tligwy, and the Sledder. They all meet in Betws-y-coed. And we are going to have a 5-minute walk from where we park the coach. Sadly, we can't park outside the hotel because it's a busy road and there's absolutely no parking outside. So we will walk from the coach park, 5-minute walk, following the River Tligwy, and then we will cross over a busy road. I will help you to get across the road as much as I can. Don't forget, please, that if you're... and I'll bring you lunch. We have had two vegetarian on this coach and two on the one behind. So 4 vegetarians in total. Please make the people who are ordering your drinks aware that you are one of the 4 vegetarian orders. There's also a guy that doesn't want chicken, but he's on the one behind. He doesn't like chicken. So he's on the coach behind. So we don't need to worry about that. But do make the staff aware. They do serve you very, very quickly. So once you've had your lunch, it's up to you to have a wander around. You need to make your own way back to the bus, to the coach. Kai will not move it. He will be back. It's fairly straightforward. You just walk straight forward, across the road, straight down, left round the TIC, which is the tourist. That's 2 drivers, 2 guides. We'll be somewhere in the hotel as well. So if you have any burning questions, then you can come and find us and ask those. We'll be happy to help. Anybody who needs an ATM, I'll point out where.
The River Conwy.
Going over the River Conwy, across the suspension bridge we saw earlier on in the tour this morning. All part of this road we're on right now, which is a road from London to Holyhead. It's called the A5 Road. And this is called the Waterloo Bridge because it was opened in 1815, which was the date of our victory over Napoleon Bonaparte. It's in present day Belgium.
Sometimes I get the movie.
I
need smaller fingers or bigger buttons.
Again, if you don't, he passes lunch and then he'll be back by 2 o'clock. If you were to be here at the weekend, it's overrun with bikers. It's a big biking destination. But you will see a lot of people with dog as well, very popular with dog walks. Families bring their dogs out for the weekend and take them around Betws-y-coed and the river and everything else. Some nice walks around here. Just there on your left.